For all those iOS developers out there who've been desperate to make money as a side hustle, this is the list you've been waiting for. But as always, there are fine details that you have to work through that impact not just how much money you will make as a side hustler, but also how are you going to earn that money. What are the best 5 hustles for programmers? Let's find out. Before I jump into the 5 side hustles for programmers, let me remind you about Cyber Monday. The link is in the description. 50% off all of my products. Go ahead and check it out. So, of course, you want to get a job as a developer. That is your aim. And maybe you do have a job, maybe you don't. But if you most probably, if you clicked on this video, you are looking a way to make some more income with side hustles. Now, if you do have a job, don't quit your job. Of course, this is a side hustle. Of course, if you don't already have a job, you can also make money with these side hustles, but that will be your main hustle. Believe me, if you have a job, that's much more easier than you don't have that stress on yourself. So let's find out what is another way of getting some money in the house without, well, besides getting a job. Well, you actually, before we get into those 5 side hustles, I want to pay the payment for you, what you actually need to do beforehand you even can get paid for those side hustles. Basically, you want to run your own business. And there are 2 ways of doing this. You can either become an indie dev, which could be, of course, a full-time job or a side hustle, or you can become the go-to developer. So this is the I have been through all of these stages. I've been an indie developer. I've then transitioned to become the go-to developer. And hopefully, because you are watching this, you know that I'm the go-to developer for Swift UI, or at least for many people. So how can you become the go-to developer? Well, you have to market yourself. And of course, this will take a lot of time till you get to that point where you are going to get paid. So you are going to put in a lot of effort, a lot of time beforehand. That's kind of the downside of this. That's why I told you at the beginning that it's kind of much, much easier if you already have a full-time job. So what do you have to do before you even get to those 5 side hustles that I'm going to talk about? Well, there are 3 things that I would like to highlight here. I've been through all of them, and it's not like you just go through these 3 things and then you forget about it and then you get paid, you go to those side hustles. No, this is an ongoing thing that you have to maintain, because again, you have to market yourself. The first thing is that you have to learn, because you want to become the go-to expert. You want to become better at your craft. And of course, you have to learn for that. You know, you have to learn new stuff that's coming out. Of course, maybe you want to learn some things that you don't already know. So first thing first, you have to learn. And while you are learning, you want to teach along the way. So that also takes a lot of time. Again, this is not paid. You can, of course, kind of, you know, teach here and there for a little bit of money. But because your aim is to market yourself, to become the go-to developer on this or that niche, you want to teach this for free. Now, this could be in a blog, or you can use Twitter for this, or as I'm doing it, you can leverage YouTube. YouTube is really, really powerful. But of course, this takes a lot of time and it requires another skill. You have to learn, besides development, you have to learn how to communicate. You have to learn how to teach, how to convey all of that knowledge that you already have. And by the way, if you teach, you will learn even better. That's what I found out. And first, you have to have a presence, as a social presence. So it's not enough to just simply post a YouTube video and that's just it. No, you have to be on the social networks, be it on, I don't know, YouTube, Twitter, TikTok, Instagram, you name it. You have to be active on that. You have to engage with your audience. You have to guide them. You have to teach them. Of course, all of this, you know, the social social presence has to be, of course, free, and it will take a lot of time. So learn, teach, and have a presence, and that will take a lot of time. Of course, you have to make this presence really on purpose. So you are just not just going to scroll TikTok or Twitter 30 minutes a day. You have to be active. You have to post. You have to engage. You have to comment on other people's. And of course, you have to help. Now, after you learn that you have to learn, teach, and be present on social, then you can incrementally add in these five side hustles that I'm just going to go through from least effective to the most effective. So let's just start off with number one, and that is freelancing. Of course, you know, you most probably heard about freelancing. Maybe you did consider doing that. There are tons of sites doing that, but there's a huge downside here. While you can get work, there most probably always be somebody who is going to outbid you. So this is kind of a race to the bottom on the pricing, and actually you don't really want that. Also, I want to note that there's an upside for this. And the upside is that if or when you are going to win a project, then you are going to have experience. And of course, you are going to communicate with the client. You are going to build that project out. And also you will be able to have or build this portfolio. Of course, you can just build your own portfolio on GitHub, but that's another way of creating your presence. So freelancing is one side hustle that you can take a look at, but it will take up a lot of time and it does not give you that much earning, at least at the beginning. Maybe you're going to build up a huge brand for yourself as a freelancer, but at the beginning, it's really, really hard because the competition is much, it's really, really huge. Second is mentoring. Now, you already know that I do have a mentoring option, so you can just go to rebeloper.com/mentoring, and then you can just book a 1-hour Zoom call with me, and then I will just basically do whatever you'd like about Swift UI. If you have a question about your code, or maybe you have a bug, I can most probably fix it because I have a lot of experience. Again, this is why you want to learn and teach and have a presence, because and of course build things, because now you will be able to mentor other people. Now, this could be like teaching one-on-one lessons, or you could just also have a counseling session. So maybe other companies will just hire you because of your expertise. Again, you have to be the go-to developer on that certain niche. You will just give them some feedback on their, I don't know, their project, how they would like to build out their next app, and so on. So number two was mentoring. Number three is courses. Now, why is courses a little bit better than mentoring? Well, while you are going to create your course only once and then just publish it and market it, your mentoring sessions will be always live. It will always take up that chunk of time. So you want to automate that. And courses is a really good way of doing that. You are going to do the same kind of teaching stuff, but always make sure that you kind of ask your audience what is it that they want to learn inside courses. And then what they are struggling with, you are going to provide a course for that. Number four is products. Now, maybe video courses like teaching stuff is not what your audience will want. Maybe they will want products. And as you already can see on my site, store.rebeloper.com, you will see a lot of products like StoreKit Pro or a navigation stack, and just to name a few. There are a lot more. Go ahead and check out Cyber Monday deal. The link is in the description. So you can purchase these codes, or on the other hand, you will be able to build these codes that makes other developers' lives easier, and then you can just sell it. So that's number four, products. Number five is the most efficient, in my opinion, and that is to build a community and then have a paid version of it, meaning that you are going to have a subscription. Now, this is a little bit a lot more than just a one-time purchase of a course or a product. It's an ongoing, so you will get a monthly recurring revenue, which is really, really nice. What you need to know right over here is that you have to cater your community, you have to take care of your community, you have to know what your community wants and then provide it inside that paid wall. And of course, you have to make sure that your community is nice and clean, there are no bad apples in there. So yeah, it's a little bit different than just publishing a course and maybe marketing it and then somebody pays for it and that's it. It's a monthly recurring revenue. And also, please note that there will be churn, so people will unsubscribe. But as you are just marketing it, you are going to get better at it. So there you have it. You have five of the best side hustles that a programmer can have. Now, if you like this video, go ahead and check out. Again, Cyber Monday link is in the description. 50% off all of my products, my courses, it's down there. Go ahead and check it out.